Yesterday at Adobe Max, Adobe announced new tools and features. So in this video, we're gonna look at top three new updates to Adobe Illustrator. So the first one is text to vector. So go to Illustrator and draw a rectangle, and then you can click here and input your prompt. Like for example, a lion head minimalist style. Hit generate. And there you go. We have a vector generated, as you can see, just by using a text prompt. Here is the first option, second one, and the third one. I really like the second one. So we have four options: subject, scene, icon, and pattern. So we use the subject, which is best for this type of images, but you can also create a scene. You can create an icon. It's also good for logo designs. And you can create seamless patterns, which is really great. And then you can also use this generative recolor feature where you can basically apply some colors on those vectors. Like for example, this one looks pretty good, doesn't it? Now the second feature allows you to create mockups. So we can just scale it down a little bit by holding shift and then go to window, mockup beta. And right here, you can generate some mockups, which will basically take the vector and apply on those different examples of mockups. But what's really cool about that is that you can find any photo on the internet, and then you can select those two objects and go ahead and create a mockup out of that. And there you go. As you can see, we have the mockup, and we can move that image, and it's gonna distort this accordingly to our mesh. So this is pretty amazing. We can save so much time and money, you know, looking for the right mockups or buying mockups on the internet. Now, the third great feature is called retype. So basically, you can find any logo on the internet. For example, I like this logo by Giroen. Shout out to Giroen. And you can copy that. And I really like this logo, and I would like to create my logo with the same font. So what I can do is I can go to Window, Retype, Beta, and hit enter, and there you go. Illustrator is going to figure out what font was used in this logo, and it's going to give you some alternatives as well. I think this is pretty accurate, so I can just double click on that, and now I can basically type in my text. Like I'm just gonna say something, and voila, I'm able to use the same font without searching for that font, without installing the fonts, without anything. It's pretty amazing, isn't it? So that's it. These are top three features in new Adobe Illustrator 2024. I think it's gonna make our lives as graphic designers and logo designers so much easier. What do you think? Let me know in the comments below. And I will see you in the next video.